你对我的爱 is a sound I love to hear. It's the sound of the Savior's robe as he walks into the room where people pray, where we hear praises. He hears faith. There is a sound I love to hear. It's the sound of the Savior's robe as he walks into the room where people pray.
Sing all the same. And all Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
感谢赞美上帝。
We thank and praise God.
我们又可以再一次聚集在一起来敬拜他。
For this opportunity to gather together and praise and worship Him.
每一次的聚集来敬拜他都是一个兴奋的时候。
Every time we gather, it is an exciting time.
因为这个是一个吸引上帝的同在的时候
It is the time we draw the presence of God into our lives
所以让我们发出我们的声音
So let us express ourselves
用我们的心灵诚实来敬拜他
And we worship him in spirit and in truth
因为他是配得的
Because he is worthy
今天愿上帝的同在降临在你的身上
May the Lord's presence fill you today
愿上帝的同在进入到你的家里面
May his presence fill your household today
所以让我们大家站起来
So let us now all arise
大声的来赞美敬拜他
With a great loud voice we sing and we praise him
Amen
Amen
Hallelujah 我们一起来赞美我们的神一起来欢呼全地都要来赞美你耶稣、oh, 我们来宣告我对你的爱永不变
离开了我逼迫我的眼我的罪将称颂你到永远你的意念高过我的思想如同天高过地全地都要来赞美你我跪拜你面前称颂你山水动摇滴水改
我对你的爱，
我对你的爱永不变。
一起来唱，离开了，
离开了我的耳，我的眼，我的嘴将称颂你到永远。你的意念高过我的思想。
来赞美全地，
全地都要来赞美你。
举起双手来唱，
我跪拜你面前称颂你，山水动摇，地水改变，我对你的爱永不变。
再来一次，离开了。
了我的耳，我的眼，我的嘴将称颂你到永远。你的意念高过我的思想，如同天高过地。
全地都要，
全地都要来赞美你。我跪拜你面前称颂你，山水动摇，地水改变，我对你的爱，我对。
一起来拍掌，将荣耀归给我们的神。哦，你是配得我们的赞美。哦 ，Yes, Lord, teach us how to pray like you. We lift up this song up to your name.
Our Father, higher birth, hallowed be your name. Reveal to you are again, who you are. All things are possible, God of the miracle. Oh, let your will be done. We pray for heaven here today. All we need, forgive us everything. Help us to love as you have loved us. Now come and build your throne as we go where you go. God, our deliverer, we pray. We pray for heaven here today. Our Father high above, hallowed be your name. Reveal to us again who you are. All things are possible, God of a miracle. Oh, let your will be done. We pray for heaven here today. All we need, forgive us everything. Help us to love as you have loved us. Now come and build your throne as we go where you go. God, our deliverer, we pray for heaven here today. Your kingdom to reign.
Your kingdom come, your will be done, Lord.
Yours is the kingdom, the power and glory, now and forever. Amen.
Let's proclaim, yours is the kingdom.
Yours is the kingdom, the power and glory, now and forever. Amen. Yours is the kingdom, for yours is the kingdom, the power and glory.
The kingdom, Yeshua,
for yours is the kingdom, the power and glory, now and forever. Amen. We pray for heaven here today.
Your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven, Lord.
Oh, we praise you, Lord Jesus.
Come and reign.
Oh.
的心来敬拜我们的主，让圣灵来充满我们，来更深入的来敬拜耶稣。
有敬拜的声音发出，从最高的山到海要伸出，神的儿女要唱一首新歌，我们神要做新事，旧的事都已经过去，在基督里一切都要更新，新的眼界，新的意象，新的故事，新的方向，全地都要渴望要的主，我愿你来，天要敞开，恩膏倾倒下来，神国度的荣耀彰显，全地都要渴望要的主，我愿你来，神灵引领，看见新的意象，你要做新的事在我们中间，
用心灵诚实来敬拜。
有敬拜的声音发出，从最高的山到海要伸出，神的儿女要唱一首新歌，我们神要做新事，旧的事都已经过去，在基督里一切更要更新，新的眼界，新的意象，新的故事，新的方向，神国度的荣耀彰显，全地都要渴望呼喊荣耀的主，我愿你来，神灵引领，看见新的异象，是在我全地都要渴望，来呼喊，呼喊荣耀的主，我愿你来，天要敞开，恩膏倾倒下来，神国度的荣耀彰显，全地都
圣灵啊，来引导。
圣灵引领，看见新的像，你要做新的事在我们中间。
哦，我们来自由的敬拜。哦，我们来祷告，让圣灵来充满我们。求神来做一件新事在我们的生命中。哦，那把心，哦，阿拉巴索，你阿拉巴心。主，我愿你来，天要敞开，恩膏倾倒下来，神国度你荣耀彰显，全地都要渴望呼喊荣耀的主，我愿你来，圣灵引领，看见新的像，你要做新的事在我们中间。 Holy Spirit, come and renew us. Oh, we yearn for your kingdom to come, Lord. Fill us with the Holy Spirit. Oh, hallelujah. Even as we sing the last song,Let's raise up our hands, because there's power in the name of Jesus. There's power in our Father's blessing. Oh, we are so blessed by you, Abba Father.
The Lord bless you.And keep you, make his face shine upon you, and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
Once again, the Lord bless you.
Lord bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you, and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
Yes, we receive.Sing Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Let's receive from the Lord. You sing Amen.
Amen. Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
Sing amen. Let's receive. Generations. down the road, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We give thanks for everything. May your name be praised. We give you all glory and honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
感谢主，今天我能够有再有机会跟大家分享上帝的话。
I want to thank God for the opportunity to share the word of God with you once again.
这一个周末是一个很特别的周末。
This weekend is a very special one.
因为是一个父亲节的周末。
Because it is the Father's Day weekend.
我要祝福所有的父亲们。
I want to bless all the fathers.
愿上帝的恩宠临到你的身上。
And that the Lord's grace and His blessing fall upon you today.
让你的灵与魂与身体都兴盛。
That you will be prosperous in your spirit, in your soul, and in your body.
Amen.
Amen.
所以今天我的题目是父亲的爱。
Today, my topic is the Father's love.
让我们来读今天的经文。
Let's read the scriptures for the day.
生命记第六章第一节到第七节。
Deuteronomy chapter 6 verses 1 to 7.
让我们一起开声的来念。
Let us all read the scriptures aloud together.
我们先念中文的，才念英文的。
We will read in the Mandarin and then the English.
生命记第六章第一节到第七节。这是耶和华你们神所吩咐教训你们的诫命、律例、典章，使你们在所要过去得为业的地上遵行，好叫你们子子孙孙一生敬畏耶和华你的神，谨守他的一切律例诫命。这是我所吩咐你们的，使你的日子得以长久。以色列啊，你要听，要谨守遵行，使你可以在那牛奶与蜜之地得以享福，人数极其增多，正如耶和华你列祖的神所应许你的。以色列啊，你要听，耶和华我们的神是独一的主，你要尽心尽性尽力爱耶和华你的神。我今日所吩咐你的话都要记在心上，也要殷勤教训你的儿女，无论你坐在家里，行在路上，躺下起来，都要讨论。
Deuteronomy chapter 6 verses 1 to 7. Now this is the commandment, and these are the statutes and the judgments which the Lord your God has commanded to teach you, that you may observe them in the land which you are crossing over to possess, that you may fear the Lord your God, to keep all His statutes and His commandments which I commanded you, you and your son and your grandson, all the days of your life, and that your days may be prolonged. Therefore hear, O Israel, and be careful to observe it, that it may be well with you, and that you may multiply greatly as the Lord God of your fathers has promised you, a land flowing with milk and honey. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul, and with all your strength. And these words which I command you today shall be in your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children, and they shall talk of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up.
首先我要解释一下，今天的这篇道不是单单讲给父亲听的。
First, I'd like to be clear that this message is not spoken only to fathers.
这一篇道是讲给教会每一个人听的。
This message is for everyone in the church.
如果你是一个还没有结婚的年轻人，
If you are a young person who's not married yet,
你要留心听这篇道。
You want to listen carefully.
做男的，你要留心听，因为以后你要知道怎么做一个好的父亲。
If you are the young man, you must listen carefully because one day you're going to be a good father.
如果你是个年轻的女孩子，还没有结婚的话，你也要留心听。
If you're a young lady and not married, you will also want to listen carefully.
因为你要为你的丈夫祷告，以后他会成为一个好的父亲。
Because you're going to pray for such a husband that the Lord will bring you, that he may be such a kind of father.
当然，如果你是父亲的话，这一篇道你更要留心听。
But today, if you are a father, then this is for you.
那万一 你在家里面没有父亲的话
，In case there is no father in your household，
你也要听。
You will also want to listen to this。
如果你是一个单亲妈妈的话
，If you are a single mother，
今天我要鼓励你。
Today I want to encourage you，
因为你身负很重大的责任。
Because you are bearing a great responsibility，
你要。不但要做一个扮演母亲的角色，你也要扮演父亲的角色。
You're playing the role not only of a mother, you're also playing the father's role.
我可以说难为你了。
And I can understand the difficulty that you go through.
但是上帝要给你恩典。
But the Lord is going to give you grace.
让你做人不能够做到的事情。
That you will accomplish what is not easy.
做一个好的母亲，同时也做一个好的父亲。
That you can be a good mother and still play the role of the father well.
我要特别向你的儿女们说话。
I want to speak to children.
你要加倍的爱你的母亲。
You have to love your mother in a tremendous way.
因为这是不容易的。
Because it is not an easy task.
你要感激他。
You have to be grateful to your mother.
你要为他祷告。
You have to pray for your mother.
你更要加倍的顺服他。
And then you have to be extra obedient to your mother.
因为他正在一个人要担任两个人的角色。
Because she is playing two roles for you.
我要跟那些年纪已经大的父亲和母亲们说话。
I also want to speak to the fathers and the mothers who are already mature.
可能你的孩子已经长大了。
Maybe your children have grown up.
你这个时候没有办法改变他们。
You may feel that you have no chance to change your children.
但是你可以为他们祷告。
But yet you can pray for your children.
你也可以及时的做一个好的父亲。
You can still continue to be a good father from today.
为他们来祷告。
You can pray for them.
所以这一篇的信息是给全教会每一个人听的。
So this passage, this message today is for the whole church.
但是在听这篇道的时候，我有两个条例，希望大家能够遵守。
But before I go into the message, I have two conditions that I request that you observe.
第一个条例是给太太的。
The very first condition is for the wives.
请你千万不要用我这一篇道来敲你的丈夫的头。
Please do not use this message and use it as a weapon and knock it on your husband's head.
不要让你的丈夫很讨厌宋牧师。
Don't make your husband get angry and hate Pastor Song.
因为这不是我讲这篇道的目的。
Because this is not the intent of my message today.
你应该肯定他。
You are here to affirm him.
你应该称赞他。
You are here to give him praise.
你应该尊重他。
You are here to give him praise.Honor and respect.
他做的不完全的地方，你应该为他祷告。
Wherever your husband is not perfect, you are to pray for him.
因为每一个成功的男人背后都有一个女人。
Because for every successful man is a woman who's supporting him.
这个女人不是一个来批评论断她丈夫的女人。
This is not a woman who criticizes and nags the husband.
而是尊重，而是支持，而是鼓励，而是为她丈夫祷告的女人。
But it is a woman who respects, honors, and encourages the husband.
所以我请每一位太太要遵守我今天列下的这个条例，你才听这篇道。
So therefore, I state here the first condition for the wives that will listen to today's message.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
那一些做孩子的
and for the children,
当你听了这篇道之后
after listening to this message,
千万不要用这篇道来衡量你的父亲。
Do not take this message and then compare and judge your father.
如果你的父亲没有做到我今天所分享的这个内容的话
If your father doesn't match up to what I have described of a good father today
如果 99% 他都没有做到
Even if he was 99% away from that
但是如果他做到 1% 的话
But if he's achieved 1%
我请你记得这 1%
And I request you to remember this 1%
带着感恩的心来感谢你的父亲做到了这百分之一。
That you have a grateful heart and towards your father for that 1%.
尊重他，肯定他。
To respect him and to affirm him.
然后为他的99%他还没有做到的，为他祷告。
And for the 99% that could be a shortfall, pray for your father.
不是为了他，是为了你自己。
Not for the father's sake, but for your own sake.
但是如果你说我在家里面没有父亲
，But if you say I don't have a father in my family,
我的父亲不在我的家里面
，My father is not here with me.
没关系的
，That is still okay.
你有一个更好的父亲，就是我们的天父。
You have a better father, the heavenly father.
他比我们世上任何的父亲都来得好。
He far exceeds any father you can find on earth.
他会比我们更好的来看顾你。
And he will take good care of you.
所以你要提起你的信心。
Therefore, you should be lifted up in your faith.
亲近你的天父。
To draw near to God, your father.
Amen.
Amen.
当我们听了这两个条例之后，我现在就会开始讲今天的道。
Then after I've laid down these two conditions, let's dive straight into the message.
在生命记第六章里面，给我们看到上帝很清楚的吩咐一个父亲，你要怎么做成一个好的父亲。
God establishes very clearly in Deuteronomy chapter 6, verses 1 to 7, how to be a good father.
首先圣经告诉我们说你要尽心尽意尽心尽力爱主耶和华你的神。
First, God says that we have to love your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and all your strength.
今天我要告诉所有做父亲的，你要尽心尽意尽心尽力爱主你的神。
So I want to tell all fathers today, you have to love the Lord with all your heart, with all your soul, and all your strength.
因为当你这样爱上帝的话，上帝会指引你走上一条蒙福得胜成功的道路。
Because if you love your God in such a way, God is going to lead you on a path of success and blessing.
当你全心爱上帝的时候，上帝还有什么好处会不留给你了？
If you love the Lord God with all your heart, why would there be anything that is good that God would take away from you?
上帝只会把最好的赐给你。
He is going to give you the best unreservedly.
你不但要这样的爱上帝，而且你要爱上帝的话，上帝的律例，上帝的诫命。
Not only would you love your God in such a way, you want to love His word and His statutes and teachings.
Because 上帝跟上帝的话是不能够分开的。
Because you cannot separate God from His word.
当我们说我们爱上帝的话，我们也要爱他的话语。
When we say that we love God, we must love His word.
当我们没有珍惜他的话，没有尊重他的话，同样的，我们乃是告诉上帝，我们没有尊重你。
When we do not treasure the words of God and honor the words of God, we are indirectly saying to God that we don't honor Him.
在生命记第六章，上帝很清楚地告诉所有的父亲。
God is very clear in Deuteronomy 6 when He speaks to the fathers.
把我的话，把我的律例典章藏在你的心里面。
He says you have to keep that word in your heart.
而且你要用它来教训你的儿女们。
And you shall use this to teach your children diligently.
以便你的子子孙孙能够蒙到上帝的祝福。
So that your generations and the generations after you will be blessed by the Lord.
你在家里面要用上帝的话来教导他。
In your house, you're going to teach your children the Lord's word.
你行在路上，躺下来，都要起来讨论上帝的话。
When you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up, you're going to teach your children.
当我们每次讲到父母亲的爱的时候，
Whenever we talk about father and mother's love,
我们总是提到母亲的爱是何等的伟大。
We talk about the greatness of a mother's love.
但是你会很惊讶地发现到，圣经里面第一次提到的爱却不是母亲的爱。
But yet you might be surprised that the very first mention of the word love in the scriptures does not describe a mother's love.
圣经第一次提到的爱确实是父亲的爱。
The very first mention of the word love in fact refers to that of a father.
它是记载在创世纪第二十二章第二节里面。
The first record of the word love is in Genesis chapter 22.
上帝告诉亚伯兰说：“把你所爱的以撒献上给我。”
Where God calls Abraham and to say, "Offer up the son whom you love as a sacrifice to me."
我们都相信爱是一个很重要的主题，在圣经里面很重要的一个主题。
We all know that love is a mighty and important theme throughout scriptures.
但是为什么圣经来到第二十二章，到亚伯拉罕年老的时候，他才提起这个字爱呢？
Why is the word love only mentioned at such a late stage after 22 chapters in Abraham's late years?
因为圣经要传达一个很重要的信息。
Because God is giving us a clear message.
就是父亲的爱是很重要的。
The importance of the Father's love.
因为亚伯罕献上以撒的这件事情其实是一个隐儿，他真正的表现出就是天父把他自己所爱的儿子耶稣基督为你为我牺牲在十字架上。
The story of Abraham offering up Isaac to God is a foreshadow of the Heavenly Father's expression of his plan that Jesus will be offered for our sake.
父亲们，
Fathers,
你的爱要直接的反映上帝的爱。
Your love directly reflects the Heavenly Father's love.
圣经把你的爱看成是一个很重要的爱。
God sees your love in the same way as the way He loves His children.
所以圣经第一个讲到爱的就是讲父亲的爱。
That is why the first mention of the word love applies to a father's love.
今天如果时间能够倒流的话，
If I could turn back time today,
如果我能够回复三十年前的话，
If I can turn back my life 30 years previously,
我会用完全不同的方式来养育我自己的孩子。
I would have treated and brought up my children very differently.
你知道为什么吗？
Do you know why?
因为这四五年来，当我筑坛祷告的时候，
In these 5 years where I learned about the prayer altars,
我里面经过一个很大的转化。
I have gone through a great transformation on the inside of me.
对上帝的看法，对教会，对侍奉，甚至对家庭，我都起了很大的变化。
There is a great change in the way I see God, the way I understand church, the way I see my service, the way I see my family.
我没有办法跟你形容在我里面经过了是何等大的一个改变。
I cannot fully describe in words the change, the transformation that is inside of me.
有的时候我内心里面会叹息。
Sometimes I would but sigh.
为什么我不早点知道呢？
Why didn't I know this earlier?
为什么三十年前当我的孩子还小的时候我不知道这件事情呢？
Why did I not realize this 30 years ago when my child was still young?
为什么那时候我没有注重在这些事情上？
Why did I not place importance in these different things?
但是这一些懊悔，这一些叹息是没有用的。
But these sighs and these regrets are useless.
没有一个时间是太迟的。
But there is never a time that is too late.
只要我们活着，我们都能够经历这个改变。
As long as we are still alive on this earth, we can experience God's transformation.
所以今天我要跟你分享，如果我能够年轻三十年的话，我会怎么样的来养育我的孩子。
So today I'd like to share, if I could turn back time 30 years back, how I would have brought up my children differently.
第一个我会做的事情
The very first thing I would do
就是我会加倍的爱我的太太
I would multiply the times of which I would love my wife
你们可能觉得奇怪
You may wonder
为什么我们今天讲了父亲的爱又会现在讲到爱太太呢
Aren't we talking about the father's love? Why are you talking about loving your wife?
我不是在讲这个养育孩子吗？为什么会讲到爱太太呢
Are we not talking about bringing up children? Why are you mentioning loving your wife?
因为
Because
你给你太太的爱，你对你太太的爱会是给你的孩子最好的礼物。
Because the level to which you love your wife is the intensity of the value of your gift to your children.
因为一个丈夫对太太的爱将会是这整个家庭幸福的这一个根基。
The quality of your love for your wife is the foundation for the happiness that is in your family.
如果我能够年轻三十年的话，
If I could turn back time 30 years,
我会加几倍的爱我的太太。
I would increase the amount of my love for my wife.
Amen.
Amen.
你知道当夫妻生活在一起的时候，
You know, when a husband and wife lives together,
有的时候我们会有争执，有的时候会有不同的意见。
We may have different opinions, we may even have conflicts.
在这几年我学会到 怎么样的去面对这些不同的意见，不同的争执。
In these few years, I've learned how to manage conflicts.
首先第一点，
The very first point.
如果你的太太给你一些指责，
If your wife criticizes you,
不是很大的，
But it is a small matter.
或者是不是直接而是间接的，
And maybe it is offered indirectly.
我鼓励你，
My encouragement to you,
要用微笑来胜过他。
You will have to respond and to overcome with a bright smile.
要说 Hallelujah, 感谢赞美主。
And to say Hallelujah, praise God.
因为当你说 Hallelujah, 感谢赞美主，用微笑的时候，你就得胜了。
Because when you say Hallelujah, praise God with a bright smile, you have overcome.
那如果你的太太给你的指责是很严厉的，
But if your wifecriticizes you something quite seriously,
直接的
and rather directly,
而且是很生气的
and she might even be angry,
那你千万不要讲 Hallelujah,
please do not say Hallelujah,
因为你讲 Hallelujah 的话会更生气
she will be even madder at you,
那你要怎么样来面对这样的一种指责责备呢？
So what would be an appropriate response in that situation?
克雷克教导我们一个很好的方法。
Craig Hill taught us a good approach.
当你的太太很生气的责备你的时候，
When your wife is mad at you and is scolding you,
你要这样的回答她说，
This is the way you should respond.
亲爱的，
Dear,
我很抱歉我伤了你的心。
I am sorry that I have hurt you.
我可以，你可以让我知道我在哪一方面使到你觉得我不尊重你吗？
Can you tell me in which area I have not respected and honored you?
你千万不要用理由来回答他。
Please do not reply and respond with reasoning.
因为当你太太很生气的责备你的时候，你跟他讲理由的话，他你越讲他越生气。
Because when your wife is mad at you and she's scolding you, she will never use reasoning.
因为太太是不讲理由的。
Because wives will not reason in that situation.
太太们不要生气啊。
Wives, do not be angry.
因为男人跟女人是不一样的。
Because men and women are so different.
我们男人是用理性，用理由去解决问题。
Men use their reasoning and their intellect to resolve problems.
女人是用心，用感情，用感受来分享出来的。
And women, you use and you respond by your heart and your feelings.
所以当你的太太很生气的时候，她讲出她的感受的时候，她并不是要你来用理由来说服她。
When your wife complains and scolds you and she's angry, she's not looking for a reasoning from you to explain things away.
所以你越讲理由，她会越生气。
So the more you reason, the more she's going to be angry.
相反的，你要进入到她的内心，她的感受里面。
On the other hand, you have to come into her heart, into her feelings.
跟她道歉。
To apologize to her.
请她分享她的感受是什么。
You invite her to share with you how she feels.
那我知道这个是很不容易的。
I know that it's not easy at all.
因为很多的时候，做丈夫的在那个时候，他会感觉到很委屈。
Because the husband at that time feels defensive.
他很想讲理由。
He wants to explain himself.
那如果你没有办法谦卑你自己跟他道歉的话，
But if you have no way of humbling yourself down and ask for forgiveness,
那我鼓励你用第三种方式。
Then,I encourage you to take the third option.
学习主耶稣的样子。
To learn what Jesus did.
被骂不还口。
Even when insulted, you stay silent.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
因为当你被骂不还口的话，那是没有办法吵架起来的。
Because when even under an insult and you do not respond, then there shall be no quarrel.
因为吵架需要两个人吵起来的。
Because it takes two.To quarrel.
一个人是吵不起来的。
A person cannot quarrel with himself.
你学习主耶稣的样子。
So learn to be like Jesus.
如果耶稣都能够被骂不还口，更何况你跟我呢？
If Jesus could be reviled and insulted without responding, so you can you.
然后过后，当你的内心平静下来之后，
And after you have calmed down.
拉住你太太的手
，Hold your wife's hand，
看住她的眼睛
，Look into her eyes，
做六分钟的祷告
，And do that six-minute prayer。
我相信这六分钟的祷告就会解决所有的这个误会纷争。
I believe that six-minute prayer is going to take away all arguments and misconceptions。
我要跟所有的丈夫说这样的话。
I like to encourage all husbands.
因为你是男人
because you are the man.
因为你是丈夫
because you are the husband.
所以你一定要让你的太太
So therefore, you must give way to your wife.
因为圣经说她比你软弱
because Bible says that she is the weaker vessel.
你先要谦卑下来
You have to humble yourself.
你才能够成为一个仆人式的领袖
that you can be a servant leader
加倍的爱你太太吧
increase your love for your wife
因为你越爱她的话她就会越成为一个越好的母亲
because the more you love your wife the better a mother she is to your child
那你的孩子就会蒙福了
and your children will be blessed
第二个
second
我会做一些我以前不做的事情
Something I would do differently if I could turn back time.
就是我会从小陪着我的孩子读圣经。
I will read the Bible with my children from their youth.
从三岁的时候，我就要开始的来跟他讲圣经的故事。
When they are 3 years old, I'm going to tell them Bible stories.
可能到五岁的时候，我就开始跟他一起读圣经的故事。
At 5 years old, I might read the Bible together with them.
那么到了六七岁的时候，我就跟他一起陪他一起读圣经神的话。
And when he's 6 or 7, I will continue to read the Word of God with them.
因为圣经神的话将要使他这一辈子活在这一个蒙福成功得胜的道路上。
Because a child that is growing up and establishing the Word of God is set on a path of blessings.
因为你看，你想想看，犹太人他们只占了全世界0.2%的人口。
If you look at the Jews, they represent 0.2% of the human population.
但是他们却拿了22%的诺贝尔奖学金。
But they occupy 22% of all Nobel Prize winners.
为什么会是这样呢？
Why do they have a disproportionate success over
the other people? 因为一个犹太人孩子五岁的时候，他的父亲就会带领他来读摩西的五经。
Because in the Jewish family, since a child is 5 years old, the father would begin to teach him the first 5 books of the Bible.
在生命记第六章第八节到第九节里面
You see in Deuteronomy chapter 6 verses 8 and
9 他说要把那个经文放在你的额上把经文放在你的手臂上
Regarding the word of God he says you shall bind them as a sign on your hand and they shall be a frontlet between your eyes and you shall write them on the doorposts of your house
直到今天犹太人还是这样的做
And even to today the Jews do that
他们真的把圣经放在他们额上，放在他们的手臂上。
They tie the scriptures on their forehead. They tie the scriptures on their hands.
要不要我们的教会开饭的时候，我们每一个人进来教会的时候，我们都把一个经文放在额上，放在手上？要不要我们一起来做
？Shall we do that as a church when the circuit breaker is over and we gather together? We come to church with the Bible tucked to our arm.And our forehead.
我想有很多人会觉得很不好意思，很难为情，很尴尬。
Some of you may feel shy or embarrassed to do that.
你知道为什么吗
？Why?
因为我们基督徒跟犹太人对待上帝的话语有不同的态度。
Because as Christians, we look at the Word of God so differently from how the Jews look at the Word of God.
犹太人把上帝的话、上帝的律法放在一个很崇高的地位。
The Jews take the Word of God and place it in such a high position of importance in their life.
他们非常的尊重上帝的话。
They honor and they respect the Word of God.
他们甚至连写“上帝”这个字，他们也不敢把它完全的写出来。
They don't even write the word God.
因为他们非常的敬畏这位上帝。
Out of that immense respect for their God.
相反的，我们基督徒没有这样的一种敬畏上帝的话的这种态度。
On the other hand, many Christians, we don't have that sense of honor and respect for God's word.
我们连甚至连上帝的话我们都不去读它。
And we may not even read the word of God.
我们宁愿花时间在玩游戏，在看电视节目，在看各样的娱乐，我们也不愿意花时间读神的话。
We would rather rather play computer games, we rather just watch TV than to read the word of God.
求上帝今天怜悯我们。
May the Lord have mercy on us.
上帝的话能够使到你成为一个蒙福得胜成功的人。
The word of God is going to cause you to be blessed and successful.
因为在约书亚记第一章第八节，圣经这样的说。
Because Joshua in Joshua chapter 1 verse 8，
他说：“这律法书不可离开你的口，总要昼夜思想，好使你谨守遵行这书上所写的一切话，如此你的道路可以亨通，凡事顺利。”
Joshua chapter 1 verse 8 says, "This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will have good success."
圣经已经很清楚地告诉我们，
Scripture clearly tells us,
你要昼夜思想神的话，以便你能够凡事都顺利，凡事都亨通。
That you shall meditate on the word of God day and night, so that your way will be prosperous and you have good success.
父母亲，今天我要呼召你起来读上帝的话。
Fathers and mothers, today I encourage you to wake up and read the word of God.
因为如果你不读上帝的话，你是没有权利，也没有这一个能力去教你的孩子读圣经。
Because if you don't read the scriptures yourself, you don't have the power to lead your children to read the scriptures.
我多么希望有一天我们全教会都是热衷于读上帝的话的教会。
I'm looking for the dayWhere everyone in our church loves to read the word of God.
我们每天早上起来都读上帝的话。
When we wake up, the first thing in our life is to read the word of God.
大量的读圣经。
To consume the word of God in large portions.
我相信如果这一天出现的话。
And when that day comes,
上帝在眼睛遍察全地的时候，他会看到这个教会如此尊重他的话的话，这个教会将会是一个特别蒙恩能够合神心意的教会。
This is a church that when God's eyes rove around the world, He is going to see a church who honors His word. He is going to bless this church.
让我们从今天开始停止藐视上帝的话吧。
So let's cease just not giving respect to God's word.
今天开始就来尊重神的话，来读神的话。
Instead of despising God's words, let's honor His word by reading it.
因为你爱上帝的话，你会爱他的话。
Because if you love His word, you will love Him.
Amen.
Amen.
所以弟兄姐妹，
Therefore, brothers and sisters,
我鼓励你陪着你的孩子一起的读圣经。
I encourage you to spend time together with your children and read the word of God.
我们现在正在计划做一件事情。
We are now in the midst of preparing something.
我们要设计一个儿童灵命塑造的一个课程。
We're preparing a program, a children's spiritual formation program.
我们希望用这个课程能够帮助父母亲在家里面如何的塑造培养他的孩子的灵命。
It is a program that parents can use within the house that they can lead their children in their spiritual formation.
所以请大家为我们祷告。
Therefore, we ask for your prayers.
希望我们真的能够发展出一套有恩膏的、蒙神祝福的一个儿童灵命塑造的计划课程出来。
That we can successfully develop this program that is highly anointed by God to touch children.
第三件我会做不同的事情就是这样。
The third thing I will do differently if I could turn back time.
我会用圣经的教训来教导我的孩子的这个道德观念。
I will use the Bible and Scripture to teach my children a moral perspective.
为什么我这样说呢？
Why do I say this?
因为今天很多的年轻人在他的头脑里面，他的那个道德观念跟圣经的道德观念是有差距的。
Because the youth of today, their moral standard and their moral worldview has a great departure from that established by the Word of God.
我不是说他们的道德观念错。
I'm not saying that they're immoral.
但是他们的道德的那个标准跟圣经的标准却有一段的距离。
But there is a big gap in the moral standard that is in their heart versus what is established in the Word of God.
因为今天这个世界上很流行这个人文主义。
Because the world we live in is a humanistic world.
而这一个人文主义所带来的道德观跟上帝的道德观是有出入的。
And the moral standard brought around by the humanistic philosophy is a great departure from the Word of God.
比如说今天许多的年轻的基督徒他并不觉得同性恋有什么问题。
For example, you might find young Christians today, they may think that homosexuality is okay.
但是从圣经无论旧约到新约里面上帝的话却很清楚地说上帝是不喜悦这样的一种性行为。
But it is clear from the scriptures, whether in the Old Testament or in the New Testament, that God dislikesAnd this approves of the homosexual acts.
为什么我们要跟着圣经的道德观念？
Why should we choose to follow the moral standards of the Word of God?
因为有一天上帝是用他的话来审判世人的。
Because the day will come when the world will be judged by his moral standards.
上帝不会照着你的道德观念来审判。
God is going to judge us by your moral standard.
而上帝是照着他自己的律法他自己的话语来审判
But God would judge us by his law and his word
因为他是全地的主宰
Because he is the creator God
我们不是主宰
We are not the creator
我们这个被造的人应该是服在他的权柄底下
We are his creation and we are subject to his authority
求上帝帮助我们每一个人
May the Lord so help us
回归到圣经里面
that we may come back to the word of God
第四点
the fourth point
我会用圣经来教导他们这个护教学
I will teach my children apologetics
让他们知道怎么维护自己的信仰
so that they have a clear foundation and a defense for their faith
为什么圣经是上帝的话
why is the word of GodThe Bible, the Word of God.
为什么耶稣基督是上帝的儿子?
Why is Jesus Christ God's Son?
为什么只有相信耶稣基督我们才会得永生?
Why do we have eternal life only through Jesus Christ?
几年前有一个教会的领袖来到我面前跟我分享他们教会的一件事情。
A few years ago, there was this church leader who shared something that happened within their church.
他说在他们的教会里面有一个孩子从小在教会的主日学长大。
And he shared about a child that grew up all his life in the church's Sunday school.
他是一个很聪明的孩子。
He was an intelligent, brilliant child.
他长大的时候他拿到了奖学金去外国留学。
As he grew up, he won a scholarship to go overseas university.
但是在国外留学的时候他面对 很多这些无神论人文主义的教授对他的信仰的挑战。
But while he was in the universities overseas, he was challenged by the humanistic teaching and the challenges even from the professors.
他们问了他一些问题但是他却没有办法回答。
They challenged him with questions and he could not answer them.
当他留学回来新加坡之后
And after he came back to Singapore,
他完全离弃了他的信仰。
He totally forsook his faith.
他成为一个无神论者。
He became an atheist.
这个教会的领袖很难过。
And this church leader was so grieved.
他说为什么会是这样呢？
He says, how could that happen?
他不是从小在教会主的学被教导成人了吗？
Did he not grow up within the church in the Sunday schools?
因为他没有被教导如何维护他自己的信仰。
The reason was he was not taught his belief, the apologetics, the nature of his belief.
今天有一个调查。
Today there's a survey.
从小到大在教会主日学成长的孩子有三分之二的他的长大之后他不是离弃信仰就成为一个不冷不热的基督徒。
The rate of backsliding ofYoungsters who grew up in the church, in the Sunday schools, is more than two-thirds.
不是主日学有什么问题。
It is not an issue with the Sunday schools.
我们的主日学，我们的儿童教会都是很棒的，都是尽全力的教导孩子们。
You have Sunday schools that have done their best to teach your children.
但是问题是，一个孩子每一个礼拜天只来教会两个小时。
But the issue is every week they only spend 2 hours in the Sunday school.
其他的时间他被这个世界来影响他。
The rest of the week they are under the onslaught and the influence of the world.
如果在家里面父母亲没有在这方面来培育他的孩子的话
，If the parents don't spend time to cultivate and to educate them。
结果这个孩子长大了之后他会很容易的就会离弃他的信仰。
The child will grow up and under the onslaught of the world's philosophies and he may lose his faith.
所以父母亲
Therefore, parents,
尤其是父亲
especially fathers,
你要来带领你的孩子你要教导他明白这个信仰是什么。
You want to lead your child, you want to teach him the reason for his faith.
第五
Fifth,
我会教导他们，他们的人生里面有一个独特的命定，上帝对他有一个独特的呼召，要他去完成他。
I'm going to teach my child that in his life, God has a unique and special calling and destiny for him to fulfill.
因为这个就是他来到世界上的目的。
Because this is the purpose for which he was placed on this earth.
上帝在他还没有来到世界上之前，已经把他对他的这个旨意和命定写在上帝的册子上。
Scripture tells us that even before the child was born, God has already laid out in detail his life and the destiny that God has intended for him.
所以当我们来到世界上的时候，我们活在世界上的目的和意义就是为了完成上帝的旨意。
So it is clear the reason why we're on this earth is to fulfill the destiny and the calling that he's had for us.
完成上帝给我们的命定。
To fulfill his calling and destiny.
因为有一天我们会站在他的宝座面前来为我们这一生来向他交账。
Because the day will come where we will stand before the throne of God and we will account for the way we live our lives in reference to our calling.
我希望我们每一个孩子都会完成他们自己独特的命定和上帝对他的呼召。
It is my hope that every child that is among us will grow up and live out the destiny and the calling that God has for him.
你知道圣经里面在马拉基书第四章有一个很特别的经文。
Do you know that there is a very unique passage in Malachi Chapter 4.
在马拉基书第四章第五节到六节，圣经这样的说。
In Malachi chapter 4 verses 5 to 6, Scripture says,
看啊，耶和华大而可畏之日未到以前，我必差遣先知以利亚到你们那里去。我必使父亲的心转向儿女，儿女的心转向父亲，免得我来咒诅偏地。
It says, Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. And he will turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and the hearts of the children to their fathers, lest I come and strike the earth with a curse.
这边讲到耶和华大而可畏的日子。
This scripture speaks of the great and dreadful day of the Lord.
那个就是主耶稣第二次再来的日子。
This is the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
但是圣经很奇怪的，在讲到主耶稣再来的日子的时候，他特别提到以利亚要来。
It seems unusual though that he's mentioned that the Elijah prophet is being sent to us.
他来的目的是什么呢？
With a purpose.
使父亲的心归向儿女，儿女的心归向父亲。
He is saying that the hearts of the children will be turned to the fathers and the hearts of the fathers will be turned to the children.
换句话说，在末世的时候，上帝有一个特别的呼召。
It means that in the end times, God has a very special calling.
这个呼召是给所有的父亲的。
The Lord is calling every father.
你要把你儿女的心归向你。
Turn the hearts of your children towards you.
你首先要把你的心归向他们。
But first, you have to turn your heart towards your children.
为什么上帝要用这样的话来提到这个末后的日子呢？
Why does God describe the end times in such words?
首先，这是因为上帝给父亲的一个期望、一个呼召、一个交给你跟我的责任。
Firstly, because this is the calling and the responsibility and God's hope for fathers.
有一天当我们的孩子如果离弃上帝的话，
that if one day our children may forsake the Lord,
上帝第一个要追究责任的就是父亲。
The first person he is going to look to for accountability is the fathers.
因为你是一家之主。
Because you are the head of the household.
因为我已经把那个责任权柄交给你。
Because the Lord has given you the responsibility and the authority.
弟兄姐妹
Brothers and sisters,
无论我们这一生在我们的工作在我们的事业上有多大的成就
No matter how great your success in your work and in your career
但是如果有一天
But if the day comes
当主再来的时候
When Jesus comes again
我们失去了我们的家人
But we have lost our family
我们失去了我们的孩子
We have lost our children
他们离弃了上帝
And they have forsaken the Lord
我想这样的情形出现的话，我们将是一个人生最失败的一个人。
We at that point of time, we will feel such a failure.
所以在末后的日子
，Therefore in the end time,
上帝有一个呼召要给所有的父亲。
God has a call that is extending to every father on this earth.
你要把你的心转向你的儿女。
You have to turn your heart towards the children.
你要为他们祷告。
You have to pray for your children.
你要关心他们的灵性。
You're going to care for their spiritual life.
如果你可以的话，你要培育他们的灵性。
If you can, you should cultivate their spiritual life.
你要门训他们。
You have to disciple them.
因为他们是你的生命的延续。
Because they are the continuation to your next generation.
现在每天早上五点起来的时候，我用很多的时间都为我的儿女们祷告。
When I wake up every morning at 5 to pray, now I spend a large portion of that time praying for my children.
因为我很关心他们。
Because I care for them.
因为我很爱他们。
Because I love them.
因为我期望他们完成上帝给他的呼召和命定。
Because I desire that they fulfill the calling and the destiny that God has for them.
我希望这也是你的一个负担。
And I hope that you too have such a burden in your heart.
当你的心转向你的儿女的时候
When your heart is turned towards your children,
你的儿女也会转向你。
The children will turn their hearts towards you.
上帝的旨意就是让我们全家都得救。
The will of God is that you and your whole household be saved.
上帝的旨意就是要祝福我们子子孙孙。
The will of God is to bless you and the generations after you.
所以今天让我们一起的努力完成上帝对我们的旨意跟呼召。
So let us all stand together to persevere towards the call of God in our lives.
Amen.
Amen.
愿上帝祝福他的话语。
May the Lord bless his word.
让我们一起站起来祷告。
May we just now all rise and we want to pray.
如果你在家里面有家人在一起的话
If you are standing with your family today
我请家人们安守在这个父亲丈夫的身上
Can I invite all family members to lay hand on the father, the husband of the house
为你的爸爸祷告
Pray for your father
为你的丈夫祷告
Pray for your husband
求上帝祝福他
Ask the Lord to bless him
求上帝兴他起来成为一个属灵的领袖
To ask the Lord to raise him up as a spiritual leader in the
如果你的丈夫或者是 你的爸爸不在家里面的时候为你的妈妈祷告
If your father or your husband is not in the house pray for the mother
你的妈妈更需要你祷告
Your mother needs your prayer
因为她负起一个很大的责任
Because she is holding a big responsibility
为你妈妈祷告
Pray for your mother
爱你的妈妈
To love your mother
听你妈妈的话
To be obedient to your mother
所以今天是孩子们为你的父母亲祷告的时候
This is the time. Today is the day to pray for your father and your mother.
如果你一个人在家的话
If you're standing alone in your house now,
我们这些做父亲的需要你为我们祷告
Those of us who are fathers, we need your prayer.
那些母亲也需要你祷告
The mothers, we need your prayer.
我请你也举起你的手来为我们祷告
We request that you pray for us.
让我们一起同心祷告
Let's unite our hearts in prayer.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
主啊我们感谢赞美你感谢你给我们如此大的呼召主啊感谢你如此的爱我们因为主啊你不要我们浪费我们这一生主啊 我们知道父母亲的责任是何等的大，你也知道父母亲是何等的不容易。今天我们求你加添我们的力量，加添我们的这一个智慧，让我们有这个能力，有智慧，能够带领我们的全家人来归向你。主啊，祝福每个做父亲的，祝福每个做母亲的。主啊，求你加添我们力量，赦免我们一切的亏欠，赦免我们对不起你的地方。主啊，加添我们力量，我们感谢赞美你，感谢赞美你。
哈利路亚，
天父，这时候我为所有父母亲来祷告。
The Heavenly Father, we thank you and we pray for the fathers.
主啊，我们感谢你，让我们能够成为孩子们的父亲或者是母亲。
We thank you that you allow us to be a father and a mother to our children.
这是一个何等荣幸的一个身份。
Oh Lord, what a wonderful privilege it is.
但是天父，我们也知道在我们的身上有很大的责任。
But we also know, Lord, the responsibility that you placed on us.
我们要带领我们的孩子来全心的归向你。
That we should lead our children to love you wholeheartedly.
今天求你赦免我们做的不够的地方。
Forgive us for the areas that we have lacked.
求你赦免我们做的不好的地方。
Forgive us for the areas where we have failed.
今天我们悔改在你的面前。
We ask for your forgiveness and we repent today.
我们求你加添我们力量。
Oh, add unto us your strength.
给我们你的聪明与智慧。
That we will have your wisdom.
让我们知道怎么样的能够更有效的带领我们的孩子全心的归向你。
That we can lead our children more effectively to come before you.
让我们全家都会尊你为大。
That our whole household will honor you as our God.
让我们全家都会把你的话语放在我们人生一个最重要的地位上。
That our whole family will place you as in the first place in our lives.
所以求你祝福我们。
We therefore ask that you bless every family.
祝福每个做父亲的。
Bless every father.
让我们的灵与魂与身体都兴盛。
That we will be prosperous, we will be blessed in our spirit, in our soul, in our body.
我们会完成你对我们的呼召和命定。
Lord God, that we will fulfill the calling and the destiny you have for us.
我们也会带领我们家人来完成你的命定和呼召。
And we will lead our family to fulfill the calling you have for them.
谢谢你听我们的祷告。
We thank you for answering our prayer.
这样的祈求祷告是奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
And we ask all these in Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
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 这时候我要为大家祝福。
Now I want to bless every one of you.
让我们举起我们的手。
Let's lift up our hands.
愿耶和华赐福给你，保护你。
May the Lord bless you and keep you.
愿耶和华使他的脸光照你，赐恩给你。
May the Lord's face shine upon you and give you grace.
愿耶和华向你仰脸，赐你平安。
May his countenance be lifted unto you and grant you peace.
奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名祝福你和你全家。
And I bless you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
you.